Okay, so here is the file in folder number 4 for chapter 3, Content Aware Invitation. And right off the bat, obviously, you can see the problem here. So the other thing is, if you want to work along with me, take your layers panel, which typically would be right here, and tear that out. Okay, there are a lot of layers on this file. So when you tear out and separate your layers panel, you can pull the bottom edge way down and instantly see all your layers. Instead of scrolling up and down a tiny layers panel, just pull the whole thing out. You can kind of set it off to the side like that. So if I have a bunch of layers here, but I really want to look at our problem area, which is the bottom layer, our background photo, you can put your cursor on the eyeball here, hold Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, and click the eyeball. That will simultaneously turn off every other layer. You can see all the eyeballs have been turned off. If you Option click this eyeball again, you can turn them back on. But you gotta watch out. There's a little glitch with this. If I Option click this eyeball, and then I turn on one other eyeball like this, then I turn it off, Option clicking here again won't work. Okay, so just be really careful with that. If that's the case, just click and drag up through the eyeballs. Okay, obviously I can do that on a small file, but if I had a file that was 300 layers, I don't want to click and drag all those eyes. But on something small like this, I can just click and drag and zip right down through those eyeballs. Okay, so here's the issue. When I took this photograph of my son 15 years ago, I never had a birthday invitation in mind. So of course, I centered him in the photograph. But now, I've added all this other information. So obviously, he can't sit in the center of our photo. I want him sitting over here on the right side of the photo. Okay, so what I can do first is try to just move his photo. So you can't move it if it's a background layer. I'm gonna double click, we'll just call that kid. And now if I take my move tool and just move him, notice, sure, I can move him over, but we have no more grass. So that's not gonna work either. Okay, I'm going to go to edit and undo that. What I have to do is keep this bottom layer filling the entire invitation, but somehow in the photo, move the kid, not move the entire photo. I still need the grass over here. So I'm going to zip through these eyeballs right there, concentrate on the bottom layer. And I'm going to let Photoshop do some automated photo retouching for me using something called Content Aware. So what I'm going to do is come down right down here, fourth tool down on the right. If I press and hold, I have a Content Aware Move tool. Okay. If you're unsure if this is set up right, what I would do is click the picture of the tool right up here, go to the gear pop-up, and reset your tools. I'll just click OK. And I didn't see anything change up here, so mine was already set to the default anyway. But right here, fourth one down on the right, press and hold, and come down to the Content Aware Move tool. So all you have to do is click and drag a big bubble around this kid. You do not want to trace right along the edges. Okay, that never works. It'll start taking chunks out of his head. So I'm going to start up here, right up in here. Click and drag up and over his head. Then I'll come down all the way around across the bottom, all the way around his shadow, and all the way back up to the start. And I'll let go of my mouse. So I've got a big bubble all the way around him and his shadow. And here's the beauty. I'm gonna turn on all my layers. And I want to mark off where the edge of the number one is, but I don't want to work with him being covered up. So I want to create a guide. Okay, on my keyboard, I can hit Command R for rulers. On a PC, that would be Control R. And right here on this vertical ruler, I'm going to hover over the ruler and click and drag it like I'm trying to pull the ruler into the image. And I'm going to line up this line right on the edge of that number one, so I kind of know where to drag him to. Now I can zip through these eyeballs and turn them off so I can see things more clearly. And with this bubble around him, I'm just going to put the same tool, Content Aware Move Tool, inside. I'll just put it on his forehead so you could see it. And I'm going to click and drag him to the right. Okay, if he kind of goes all over the place, after you start to drag, hold Shift. And you can see you can slide him straight across. So I want him to go right about there. I don't mind if I lose a little foot, but the other foot's not going to be kicking that red line. I'm going to move it over right in there, about like that. I let go of the mouse. I let go of the Shift key next, and all I have to do is hit Return, and Photoshop will calculate the duplicate and remove the duplicate. Content Aware Move. Now this bubble is still going to be left around this kid, so I'm going to hit Command D to deselect. One thing you got to understand about Photoshop is it is a good program. It is not a perfect program. I can see with the trained eye, I can see this big blurry patch of grass here. It's kind of a telltale sign that photo retouching has taken place. But you also have to keep in mind that there's going to be a bunch of stuff covering that. So I'm going to zip through these eyeballs, and who would know? Okay, 95% of that is gone. So now I've moved him out of the way. We've got our birthday party invitation, but I see a couple other things I want to change. First, I don't need this guide anymore, so I'll go to View menu, down to Clear Guides. I don't need my rulers open anymore, so Command R to get rid of those. And then I'm going to zoom in on this little weed right up here. Okay, I can hold my space bar and pull that in, or I could just click and drag left and right with the zoom tool. But I don't like this little weed. Okay, since I'm on the bottom layer, I'm going to do the simplest type of photo retouching. I'm going to take my clone stamp tool. I'm going to click on it once, come out onto the screen, and that's a really, really small brush. So on my keyboard, I'm going to hold the Control key and the Option key on my Mac, click and drag to the right. I want my brush to be a little bit bigger than that actual weed itself. And what I'm going to do is clone grass. It's really simple. I want to pick up this good grass right here and plant it on top of this weed. So all you have to do is hold your Option key on a Mac or Alt on a PC. I'm going to option click this clean grass right here. Option key and click. Then I let go of the mouse and I let go of the keyboard, and you're going to see a preview. I'm going to line that up right over the weed, click and drag, and transplant grass right on top of that weed like that. That's it. I transplanted the good grass right on top of the bad grass. Option click below, let go of everything, move over your damage, and paint to clone. I'll zoom back out, and that looks really good. The only other thing I have a problem with on this file is these two banners. You'll notice that the bottom banner is the same color as this one, but dark blue against green gets a little hard to read. Notice I've added a white stroke and a white outer glow to this bottom banner. So if I'm not sure what layer this is on, I click on my Move tool, Right up here is a button called Auto Select. So I want to make sure that is turned on. You can see the check mark. And now when I click on this bottom banner, click, it takes me to the bottom blue banner layer. You can see way over to the right, there is an FX. I've added effects to this layer. I've added a stroke effect and an outer glow. I can toggle this little arrow and it says, on the bottom blue banner layer, you've added some effects. The effects are a stroke and an outer glow. I want the top blue banner to look exactly the same, but I don't have those effects. And I don't know what values I assign to those effects. I just want to copy them. Okay, so on my top blue banner, the one I'm trying to change, I'm going to click on that layer and let go. Then I'm going to hold my Option key on a Mac or Alt key on a PC. Option or Alt means copy. So I'm going to hold Option key, put my cursor right on the word effects, and while I'm holding the Option key, I'm going to drag the word effects up to the top blue banner layer. I let go of the mouse first, then I let go of the Option key, and now I have copied the same effect. So I have that consistent look. I take my zoom tool, or I can just hit Command 0 to zoom out. Click and drag to the left a little bit more so I can zoom out just a bit more and see our final invitation. We've moved the kid over. We've duplicated the effect. We've touched up the weed. And now we've got an invitation that's ready to be sent out. So in yours, you know, move him wherever you want. I think he looks fine right there. Some people say, I want his head perfectly centered between the edge and the number one. I don't care. I just want you to know how to use content aware move, how to duplicate layer effects, and make my kid look good. So there you go. Content aware. I will switch that back to the normal spot healing brush, not be stuck way down here for later on. And I always switch back to my move tool. And I'm ready to move on to the next great file.